Peace be upon you. Today we are going to take a look at Fuduntu 2012.2 with all the updates, as it is a rolling release distribution. Now I have followed Fuduntu from its beginning. I've actually used some time back also when it was not a rolling release. See, the premise behind Fuduntu was the developer wanted to give the Fedora base with the qualities of Ubuntu, hence the name Fuduntu. Like they have taken the F and the D from Fedora and the U and the UNTU from Ubuntu. So as it says, Punny name serious distro, and a serious distro it is. So it's nice, I like it. So this is your normal GNOME 2, and they have decided to stick with GNOME 2 for as long as possible, and they are doing well. So at the top you have a panel on which you have your date and weather and the whole stuff. So this is your network indicator and your sound indicator, and this is Jupyter. Now this distribution takes pride like in the term of the performance they give, and the battery power consumption is less, as they say, compared to other distributions. And I have installed it on my desktop machine. I don't have own a laptop or a netbook, so hence you will not see maximum performance, because I am using my system is plugged in. But people say that who use this Jupyter applet say that they get good performance out of it. Then here you standard applications menu, and I will come back to the application provided by them by default, and then your places and your systems, standard GNOME 2 stuff. At the bottom you have the Avant window navigator, which they have customized, and it's a pretty simple layout, works pretty well, and no problems with that. So as you may have seen, Chromium is your default web browser, and it is the latest version 18. In accessories you get your archive manager, calculator, JDIT and Shutter, and Tomboy. Now Tomboy is my favorite note taking application, and Shutter is also great for screenshots. In graphics you only get Shotwell Photo Manager. I have installed GIMP. Let's quickly show it to you. It is the latest GIMP 2.8, and the guys at GIMP have also done a good job. So you have your single dock and your windowed mode, which is nice. This is a nice addition. Also the guys at GIMP have made a few more changes. For example, changing saving and exporting, they have differentiated it, which is also a good thing. So enough of GIMP. In internet you have Chromium, as I have stated. You get Dropbox. Google Mail is actually it's a launcher that they have created that wraps around Chromium, and when you click on Google Mail, it will launch Google Mail over here. Then I have installed Hotot, as I was checking for a micro blogging client, and Hotot is my favorite one. You have Pigeon and Ramina, Pigeon by default and Ramina remote desktop client. In Office you only get Google Docs, and it is the same way as the Gmail one. It is a launcher that is wrapped around Chromium, so when you click on it, Google Docs will launch. And I have installed LibreOffice just to check how it's functioning, the latest one, and it's functioning well. Let me quickly open it for you. Then in sound and video, Banshee media player is your default audio media player. Then Vizero for your disk burning, Cheese for your webcam stuff, and then VLC is your default video player, which is an excellent choice. I have installed Audacious and Dead Thief, and I will come back to Audacious in a moment. In system tools you get Alias, that is your system configuration and management stuff, tweaking. Then you have CD DVD creator, Deja Dub for your backup stuff, and then Jupyter, as I've already told you. And I have installed Unit Boot In and Yum Extender. Now Yum extender is an excellent application, and I highly recommend anyone trying trying Fuduntu or Fedora for that matter. So here you have entered my root password, and then it checks updates and all the other stuff. Now what happens with the Fedora based distributions and Fuduntu also, like when I install a Fedora based distribution, the update software and the, let me quickly show it to you. Yep. Software update. Now what happens is when you do a fresh installation of Fuduntu for that matter, this thing will just not move. They're waiting for package manager to log. It is because of Yum is running. Now at that time when you install do a fresh install of Fuduntu or Fedora for that matter, like I have always faced, it will go on loading and it will never finish up. So one thing that I recommended, I will put these in the description below also, is that if you also face the similar thing, then you open a terminal and put in these two commands. First you do yum list updates, and then it will update all your packages and stuff, and then to actually download and install all updates, do beesu yum update, and by that you will have the latest software as it is a rolling release. And the best part of it is, as you have installed Fuduntu for one time, you don't have to install it any like keep on reinstalling it or worry about new release installation. Now this is the you can install Yumex from add GNOME package manager. You can install it from here also. I don't like GNOME package manager. I have never liked it for some reason, and that's why I was really amazed when I found Yumex. So let me quickly show you Yumex, and I will put in the command for installing Yumex from the terminal also. So let's quickly search for an application, gpartin, and let's install it. It is really fast, it shows you what's happening, and then there are many functions that Yumex can provide, which is simply great. Let it finish. As you see, it is 42 degrees Celsius over here, and I have turned off my fan just to, so that you don't get all fan noise when you hear this. So okay, it's near completion. Okay, and when the software that you installed get installed, it will ask you whether you want to exit Yumex or don't. I will not exit now because I will show you some other things. So here, from here you can update your stuff, you can check what all is installed, what all is available. Now if there are some pending actions, then you can follow them from here. Now Fuduntu has repositories. For example, they will, as any distribution, if you want to get the repository activated by default, is the Fuduntu, that is the stable one. If you want to get a newer application faster, then you can enable Fuduntu testing, although it is not recommended as usual. And then if you want to bleed, and if you want to be on the bleeding edge, then you can tick on Fuduntu unstable also, and then try that stuff. Now it is, Yumex is not important for this, and this is the XPerfect also, and the open source drivers, the drivers, Fuduntu is a good thing in that matter, that the drivers work well, and they also take pride in, like they provide drivers for most of the laptops and their Wi-Fi cards and stuff, so you shall not have a problem with that. You can also check on the repositories from here also. So Yumex is not something that is compulsory for doing this. You can take it from here and then get to work. Also, the thing with Fuduntu is, when it was based on Fedora 14, and when the life cycle of Fedora 14 came to an end, they forked themselves from Fedora. So now they keep their repositories separate, and because of that, there are chances that some applications, for example, let me show it to you. For example, I was looking for Mumble that I used to do chatting with my friends on Linux distro community, and Mumble is not in the repositories. Similarly, other applications, for example, which one? Chukuk is also not in the repositories. So like you have options, like Hotot is there and many other stuff is there. Also Audacious has a problem that it will not run audio files. It is a bug in Fuduntu, I believe, or it's with the Audacious, but Audacious was working fine on Ubuntu 12.04 when I checked it, so don't know about that. But then there is another excellent audio media player, that is Dead Beef, that I really enjoy, and then you can play audio from here. So it works well. So all in all, Fuduntu comes with a good theming also. You have various themes available. This is your standard GNOME 2 stuff. So if you want Fuduntu Elementary, or for that matter Graphite is nice. Yep. And then change the background a bit. Okay. This was nice. I got it from Google Plus, and this is Blue Mosque in Istanbul, Turkey. And it is a good one. And then similarly, you can configure the preferences of Avant Window Navigator from here. If you want, you can add more applications by dragging and dropping them from here. Also, you can add applets from here. For example, if you want like a workspace switcher also. Now, Compass is working by default, so you get your desktop cube working nicely, no problem with that. You see, desktop cube working nicely, then you get all your effects also pretty nicely. And then I have already showed you Expo, so you already know about Expo. All in all, I am finding Fuduntu quite a good experience. And I will stay on Fuduntu for some time, because I enjoyed your softwares. Most of the softwares are available that I use on it, and then it's pretty speedy, so I like Fuduntu. Hope you also like it. Thanks for watching.